Hello, hello. I'm at Tumbleweeds in California, and I'm about to go on stage. It's awesome Beatles night going on here, and I'm going to be singing Let It Be. I'm gonna be singing Let It Be very soon. So here we've got lovely Mercy is gonna be filming. Hello, Mercy, and this is my friend Steve.
Let's stop. We're gonna raise the key up for you.
Oh, yeah. All right. Take two.
Guys, give it
a D. I'm from Australia, guys. Hello, it's great to be in California. Hello from Australia. Gold Coast. Australia. Who's been to Australia? Who's been to Australia?
The thing is,
we're in Australia.
Okay.
We're in Australia.
Here we go.
In Australia, they did this in the key of D, so we're gonna do it in the Australian.
I can Australia.
Let it be.
I must say, your English is really good.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. I enjoyed that. And just remember to let it be, guys. All right? Let it be. Just chill out a bit. Be grateful for all the beautiful things in your life. Thank you.
Yoo-hoo!
I'm grateful for you.
Very nice job.
I like my garden.
Garden,
hello. Oh my god, that's so funny.
Everybody,
so I just did Let It Be, as you probably saw that we got on the live here. Oh my god, it's so funny. Susan, hello, Adrian. Wasn't that fun? Michael, hello, Mark, Carl.
Hey, the words are different, but the story is the same.
Norma, Sean, Michael, hello, Renee. There we go. Hello, Stephen, Chris. Oh my god, that was so much fun. I am at Tumbleweeds here in California, in Huntington Beach. And here it is behind me. Look at this. That's a sign right here. There we go. See that? Tumbleweeds. Sports bar, grill, music, dancing. And so much fun. I love America. I just love it. I love this area too. California's very nice. Los Angeles, very nice. And yes, I am in Los Angeles, Renee. I just sang Let It Be in a different key, clearly, to the one that they had it in. So there you go. I just do Altman style. So they then adjusted and did Australian Altman style. And that was fun. Really cool. So I just thought I'd share that with you because it's such a cool bar here. It's such a cool bar. Look at this place. I might show you. I'll go back inside again. Now there's someone else staying.
All right. All right. Got a real solution. Well, you know, we don't love to see the plan. You ask me for a contribution. Well, you know, we'll do what we can. But if you want money for people with money,
thank you, Mercy.
you want to sing Longfellow Sally?
And there you have it. A bit of Beatles music for you from LA. It's always fun, isn't it? Such happy music, the Beatles, don't you think? Anyway, what are you guys grateful for joining me today? Yes, I am in LA and I love it here. I love traveling and I've just attended 1 week mega success event with JT Fox. It's been absolutely awesome. I interviewed Jewel and Charlie Sheen on stage in front of 2,500 people and they're from 76 countries. So it was a phenomenal experience and I'm probably looking a little bit tired because I probably am a little bit tired, a little bit jet lag still, I think. I think it takes a week to get over jet lag when you come from Australia to America, actually. I think it takes a good week to get over the jet lag because America's about 16 hours behind, also from Australia, where I am on the Gold Coast. So this is very cool. But my friends you saw in there, Stephen and Mercy, and we've had a great day today. We went to their church actually earlier, which was just great, and I had a really good chat with the pastor there. Not that I'm religious in any way, I wouldn't say. I'm spiritual. Pastor was a really interesting guy. It was just wonderful. It was really nice. It was Children's Day. They had a Children's Day festival on, and I played a table tennis tournament, and I came second. Yay! That was pretty cool. That was a bit unexpected. I was a bit out of practice, but yeah, it was fun. So I've had a really nice day here, and just taking a break, and then I'm off to Seattle for a week tomorrow. Off to Seattle, then back to LA for a few days, and then back to Australia. So. Having a great time here. I hope you're having fun wherever you are. Where are you dialing in from? Where are you coming to us from today in the world? What suburb or city are you from? And what are you grateful for today? I'm grateful for you. I'm grateful for Stephen, my friend Stephen. I'm grateful for Stephen and Mercy who brought me here today. And I'm grateful for this amazing band they're playing right now. And dinner has been served apparently, so I am going to go and eat now, which I am also grateful for food. I do love food and I love traveling. Thank you, Donna Lee. I am smashing it, I guess, in my own way. So I've always had a dream to be on big stages and speak to lots of people and interview more celebrities. I have interviewed a lot of celebrities in the past. I've interviewed Hugh Jackman, Cyndi Lauper, Debbie Harry from Blondie, Paul McDermott, Mikey Robbins, Jim Owen, Russell Crowe. There's so many celebrities I've interviewed over the years as a entertainment reporter with different media over the years. And to be face-to-face, a lot of these interviews were actually by phone, so to be face-to-face with Charlie Sheen and Jewel this week and be interviewing them was absolutely awesome. I also saw Michael Douglas this week, also Mel Gibson. Steve Wozniak, the co-founder of Apple, was at this event. It was just phenomenal. There's so many amazing performers and speakers. It was a mind-blowing event. Absolutely brilliant. And I will be back next year. It's going to be on again in November next year at the Hilton in Anaheim. And I will definitely be back for it then. So grateful for my interview tonight with my TEDx coach tonight. Okay, cool, Donnelly. Awesome. Great. Yeah, beautiful. Love it. And I'm also grateful for all my mentors and coaches too over the years because, you know, I've done a lot of work on myself, a lot of different business courses, all sorts of courses. And the event was the JT Fox Mega Success Event in LA, and it's held every year. I went last year and I was there again this year. It's a brilliant event, amazing event, great networking with people from all over the world. Very interesting people I've met this week. It's been phenomenal, and some of the business alliances and new friends I've made has been really, really cool. And Charlie Sheen, well, I love Charlie Sheen no matter what people say about him, and I love Two and a Half Men, and Two and a Half Men is not the same without him, wouldn't you say? If you're watching this and you've seen Two and a Half Men since Charlie Sheen departed, the show is just not the same without him. It's my favourite TV sitcom, Two and a Half Men, with Charlie Sheen in it. However, it is what it is. You know, things change, and we know he had some personal issues, but he was actually in really good spirits yesterday when I interviewed Charlie Sheen. He was looking a lot better than he was last year. And JT Fox did give him a very hard time on stage last year when he interviewed him, so this year he seemed to be in good spirits. And he seemed well. He said he just returned from Australia and was in LA, and you know, only just returned, so he said he had a great time in Sydney and Melbourne, and that might have helped. Maybe that's why he was looking so relaxed and looking happy. Anyway, I am good. You are the queen of self-investment. Oh, thank you, John Lee. Yes, thank you. As well as being the media queen, the queen of self-investment. Well, you know, you never learn less, as they say, and you know, when you invest in your mind, it's not something that you ever lose. You know, you always can use the knowledge in some way, and as long as you take action, of course, on it. And it could be, you know, small actions over time. They say it takes a lifetime to be an overnight success. And, you know, we're all a work in progress, and I certainly am a work in progress. And, you know, I love interviewing people, full stop, really, whether they're celebrities or not celebrities. I love interviewing people and sharing people's stories. And I will be running some workshops when I come back to Australia. I'm doing my How to Gain $1 million worth of free publicity workshop. I'm doing it in Sydney on December 5 and on the Gold Coast on December 11. It'll be 9 to 1 p.m. So if you're around and want to attend, I will have some promo on that online shortly. So December 5, Sydney, December 11 on the Gold Coast, and 9 till 1 p.m. at the Gold Coast, it's going to be at the Quality Hotel Mermaid Waters, and in Sydney it will be at the Castlereagh Boutique Hotel in the city, in the CBD of Sydney. So come along. And then on December 5 at night time, we're launching the Elevate Your Mindset series, which is a book that's been put out with in collaboration with Fiona Jones and Authentic Education. So that Elevate book will be launched in Sydney as well, and I'm very proud and honoured to be a part of that book. I've got a chapter in that book with some other amazing Aussies. So that's December 5, and I'll be back in the Gold Coast late this month, so around November 28 or so I will be back on the Gold Coast, and then basically back for a day, then off to Sydney. So it's a pretty crazy schedule. This month has been insane. Actually, this year, I don't know where this year has gone, but it's been awesome. So thanks for joining me here today. What else are you grateful for? Where are you coming to us from? I'm in Huntington Beach in LA, and I'm going to go and have dinner now. So have a great morning or night wherever you are in the world, and look forward to catching up with you again soon. Bye for now.